big fan of letting the market determine scheduling. If the market says people are watching T20, ODI, Test cricket in that order, do you schedule cricket in that order? Or are you from the school of thought that says, no, we must give the market what we think is right? Test cricket has a heritage. We can't let it go away because fewer people are watching. So you must have Test cricket. Because my fear with this ICC Test Championship is they're trying to crowd the calendar with Test cricket and creating fewer windows for T20.
I am a big believer that T20 cricket should never be played at the international level. It should only be played at World Cups. We should have a T20 World Cup every 2 years. No issue with that at all. I think it'll be a great event, magnificent event. But every other opportunity to watch 2020 cricket will only be at the franchise level. And therefore, you are driving your T20 fan to watch domestic cricket or local cricket. You watch the Big Bash, you watch the IPL, you watch whatever we have back in New Zealand. You know, it's been called five different things in the last 7 years. You watch the Ram Slam, you watch all those things because that's how you get your 2020 fix. And then every 2 years, there's a T20 World Cup and it becomes a great world event.
It's almost a football model.
I think it is. Yeah, and therefore, what the boards then do is they drive the franchises to make their own money by really pumping their own product and getting people through the gate. If you want to watch India play, if you want to watch New Zealand play in a short format game, you can only watch them play 50 over cricket. So you drive people back to that game, and then your test matches, I just think they'll take care of themselves.
You know, it's a thought that's been echoed by quite a few respected thinkers in the game as well. What do you tell television networks that are saying, you know, every time India plays a T20 international, it rates 30% more than an IPL game?
That's because India are playing. If they're not playing a T20 international, how do those people get their fix? They watch a one-day international.
But do you give them what they want then?
No, I think you dictate what they need to do. To me, I think that's how it should work. The television, the only reason that happens is because they're giving it to them. If they don't have it to watch, then they go back to watching what they used to watch. And if they want to watch T20 cricket, they go through the gate.
I don't know, in my experience, if you don't give them what they want, they go and find it elsewhere.
I don't think they will. They still love cricket. Yeah. I think a cricket lover will still want to watch India play. They still want to see their heroes. They still want to watch Australia play. And I think they want to see their heroes play in coloured clothing with a white ball, and therefore they'll also become a little more engrossed in their franchise, I think, as well.
What's the future of T20 leagues, though? At the moment, it's the flavour of the month. Everybody wants to watch T20 leagues. And then you've got one, it was to be in South Africa, it's not happening. You've got one coming up in England, but you've got the Big Bash, you've got the Pakistan League, you've got the CPL, you've got one in Bangladesh coming. Which player belongs to which team?
Yeah,
you say Messi is Barcelona. You say Ronaldo is Real Madrid.
Yeah.
You say Neymar, well, he just moved. But you know what club they stand for.
Yeah.
You say Kieran Pollard. Who's Kieran Pollard?
More clubs than Jack Nicklaus.
There you go. He's a golf lover. Yeah.
But that is a bit of an issue, I think. The franchise system around the world, if you're going to... I mean, they tried it with the Champions League, didn't they? It just didn't work because there was a monopoly.
It was a wonderful concept.
Yes, but it was never going to work if one particular league had the marquee players all the time and could keep them. So it was never going to work as an equal. I do worry that all of these 2020 tournaments crop up around the world. And I worry for the quality of the cricket because they don't all have a certain amount of money to pay the players. So therefore, is the quality of cricket as good? So that becomes
well, people get bored of that eventually. I mean, Test cricket survived 150 years.
Yeah, and I think if you go back to your point before about give the people what they want. Well, what happens when it's saturated in 2 years' time and they're sick of 2020? What do we do? Do we invent a 10-10 game because people want something even faster? And that becomes a bit of an issue. So if you keep 2020 just at a certain level where, you know, we're not playing at every other game at international level, and you are watching franchise, and you're watching good competitions around the world play, that's why I don't mind, in essence, what India do with their top-ranked players. They say, well, look, we think we've got the best 2020 league in the world, and I think they have. So we're not going to allow our players to play in the other leagues because all that does is props up the other leagues, and it gives them
and brings
a market.
The exclusivity of our leagues.
Correct. And it gives them a market in where India are strongest. They don't want that. So I actually don't mind that. But the other franchises around the world, the other countries around the world probably can't afford to do that.